Former governor of the Eastern Province, MLA M. Hizbullah, testified before the parliamentary committee to look into the April 21st attacks today.
Kathanguri Council is in under full control of you?
Yes, not under control, but my supporters are there, yes.
Why do you have named both that are in Arabic?
You know, there was no law, chairman, not to use Arabic. There was no in Sri Lanka law to attack the tourism, and especially, you know, especially Arabs, normally large number of tourist Arabs, normally these days, May, June, July, you were aware that large number of Arabs used to come.
You said that name boards in Arabic text were used to attract tourists to the area. When we visited the Kathankudi area and the Batticloa campus, we witnessed date palms grown in the middle of the road. Why are date palms grown in this country? I initially decided to plant the foxtail palm. I even went to Pasiala to order this plant. I even discussed this matter with a Sinhalese doctor in Pasiala, who is an expert in this field. He said that the foxtail palm cannot survive in such warm climates. The center of the road also concentrates too much of heat. Therefore, the plant would die. He then proposed that date palms be planted instead. I was under the impression that date palm plants could be imported. However, the quarantine department did not approve this. There is nothing special about date palm trees. The date palm is a plant that can survive the heat in the area, and that is why we planted them. Even though we are not the majority in Sri Lanka, we are the majority in the world. What does that statement mean?
There was a discussion in mosque after the Friday mosque. Not only the Eastern province, all over the country, Muslims was after these incidents very scared. So Muslims are in Sri Lanka, we are minority, but globally we are majority. So you don't want to worry about that. That's the way I said, you know, the media.
The media had edited what I said and only add this particular part of my statement. I made such a statement to give courage to the people, to restore their confidence and to encourage them to go forward with their businesses. I did not have any other idea. To be honest, I did not intend to even address the public. Are you publicly rejecting this statement? Sri Lanka is my country and I have made several sacrifices for this country. This is me addressing the parliament 3 years ago. During my address, I referred to Sri Lanka as a Buddhist country thrice. Following such remarks, the Muslim community even criticized me. After nominations for the 2015 parliamentary elections concluded, Zahran called all Muslim candidates to his office for a discussion. I was not the only one who attended this meeting. Candidates from the Sri Lanka Muslim Congress, Abdul Rahman, who contested from Kathankudi, then Shibli Farooq, they were all present.
Shibli Farooq, innawa okkoma innamithi
na Zahran trastavadi kiyanne nenda obathumada
trastavadi minimal.
He's a terrorist, there is no doubt about that. He's a terrorist and a murderer. But in 2015, he was just a leader of a religious group and was not labeled as a terrorist. We had not met Zahran and we did not know him. We only knew him as a religious leader. We lodged a complaint against Zahran, who we identified only as a religious leader and not as a terrorist. You are the prominent and leading politician in Kathankudi. All these incidents took place in Kathankudi. What was the reason for you not to be aware of Zahran's violent behavior when locals in the area were aware of it? Honestly, I was not aware of his violent behavior. If I was aware, I would have informed the relevant authorities. He acted against me. When I learned of his death, I was the happiest person on earth. I have no opposition against me when contesting for the upcoming elections. I am happy that he is not alive to contest for the upcoming elections. If he was a terrorist, I would have most definitely lodged a complaint against him.